path a la Sam McCoy. Sam McCoy was is a kind of a local legend here, one of the better jiu-jitsu guys that you're gonna ever encounter on a local level. MMA fighter, nothing but love for Sam McCoy. Everybody knows him, he's a great guy. He used to do this deep half sweep that's so effective. So he'd pull half, he had no problem pulling half against a bigger guy. He'd dig up underneath the guy. You see this? Under hook here, hand here on the butt, hand here. He'd throw the guy up and grab this right here. You guys see it? And he'd hold on to this. He'd use his right leg to make sure the guy couldn't step out. Because what happens with a lot of, especially if you're doing it to a smaller guy, you open your legs and he pulls his leg out and you're stuck. So he would first use the back heel to put it in place and then use the foot to keep it in place. Back leg to put it in place, heel to keep it in place. And then inch right in. Come up on top. You guys see it?
Sure.
Knee shield or not, didn't matter to Sam. He used his leg to open the space. Boom! Pull the guy on top of him. Immediately, he's grabbing the guy's belt back here, or his pants. This foot secures. This foot keeps it in place. He used the far side of his heel, so the guy couldn't pull it out. See that? Now, inch by inch. Come on top.
Nuances from here. So the first thing, if you're new, you're working is, this is called deep half. This is half guard. And I realize the guy's real heavy, he's cross-facing me, whatever. I have to make the space and I have to drop my ear, my left ear, in his chest. Boom! See this? I have his belt, I'm here. I take away his ability to go cross-face. Go cross-face and I keep hiding my head so he can't. What eventually he's gonna do, he's gonna sit up high enough that I drop my arm under and I go like this. Now, if he doesn't slide up from here, guys, then I'm just taking my back door. So a lot of guys do is go up high on your knee. In which case, you just take his back, right? Or what a guy like this would do also is he'll step over and face me if I don't secure. So a lot of times you go deep half and you throw the guy up and instead of grabbing the belt, watch this, swing your leg all the way over that way, face me. Yeah, just like we did in the drill. That's why it's so important to secure the guy's back. So we're here, I'm working my deep half, I open the space for my arm, I put my head in his chest, and now when I go to roll him, he doesn't roll, he pulls up to the top. Boom, yes. So Sam uses his foot, push, hand off. Now, this hand here always creates downward pressure. If you just grab this here or grab this here, you might have security, but you won't get the sweep. He pulls this down, drops his elbow, and slowly, inch by inch, starts to turn until he gets the guy over. Then he can pass. Obviously, there's a knee bar there. You see what I'm talking about?
Straight.
Right, but so the key to deep half in this situation is doing it with a guy who knows the defense. If you go deep half and the guy doesn't know the defense of sitting up on top of your head, then you're not going to be able to counter his counter. But you'll just come out the back door and take it back. Okay, so let me, Victor, one more time so you guys see the whole process. Half guard. Or half guard. Lift. Right in. I have the belt now, and all I'm doing is handing it off to the other side. Boom. A smaller guy wants to pull his leg out. I can't let him pull his leg out. This hand is holding him down. If this hand's lazy, and I go like this, a small guy just goes like that. That's what Hoffa Ravello does all the time.
He lets you pull his deep half, and then just yanks his leg out. It's miserable. Push, feed, boom. Now use this foot to slowly escape to him until you get the leverage you want. Obviously, guys, please, new guys, last thing is, put your left hand on my head. When I go to pass, triangle, don't let this happen. Miserable place. So when you pass, just make sure you don't go in a triangle. Keep that back tight. Keep that head out, okay? 1, 2, 3.